Hey, I'm Dionysius from buycombyname.com. I have already signed into my GoDaddy account and I will transfer one domain to Dynadot. I have different tabs for Dynadot and my personal email. Okay, let's start. I will click here upright, manage domains, and choose the domain that I want. I click here. And I scroll down. Before I start the transfer process, I need to mention some things. You need to unlock your domain. Click here. If it is on, you need to turn to off. You need also to disable the privacy. So privacy is off and the domain is unlocked. I also want to mention that if you just register your domain within the last 60 days, you will not be able to transfer to another domain registrar. Also, you can transfer an expired domain, but not during the redemption period. Another note is that if you renew your domain after it was expired, please do not transfer within 45 days of the previous expiration date. In that case, GoDaddy might revoke the renewal and don't issue a refund. Okay, now that we know these limitations, let's initiate the transfer. Transfer domain away from GoDaddy. You see here some notes. Continue with transfer and click here to see authorization code. I will also receive that code in my mail. The email that I was originally provided when I registered the domain name. I copy the code to clipboard and then I go to Dynadot interface. I click here upright, domains, transfer. I copy here the authorization code and the domain. I can also do a bulk transfer if I wish to. See here some additional notes from Dynadot that describe the process. And I start. I see here upright my cart, view cart. Here domain privacy is free compared to GoDaddy. Now, when I transfer a domain, I need to pay for one additional year, so it is not free. Let's check out. I will use PayPal, but you see that you have another option, credit, debit card, Apple Pay, Skrill, Bankwire. I submit order. Okay, when you use PayPal with Dynadot, they give you that link. It's a bit weird, but anyway, I will complete it here by visiting that link. Now, of course, all this process will not be instant. Let me check my mail. I have messages from GoDaddy, the PayPal email. I see here are the details from Dynadot. I need to monitor my mail all the time and junk emails or spam. That's to be sure that I saw all the relevant emails. Now, if I click here upright on my account on Dynadot and choose pending transfer, I can see more details. You see that it might take some days for the transfer to be completed. I need to monitor both accounts, Dynadot and GoDaddy, and my mail. There is one trick. You can actually accelerate the transfer. Click here upright domains, transfers, and you can see all transfers out. It's important note. Click your domain and accept transfer. So things will be much faster. I accept transfer. Okay, now I see the messages from GoDaddy. Oh, actually, it took some minutes only for the transfer. Only because I accelerate the process here. Remember, domains, transfer, and then accept the transfer. Okay, let's check now. Pending transfer here on Dynadot. Let's search for my domain. I don't see it yet. If I check the whois for the domain, I see that it's already under Dynadot. So in some minutes, I will be able to see it here in my list. And I receive the message from Dynadot. My transfer was completed. As you see here, I don't have any notification. So I can just check the list of my domains. And voila, the domain is here. That's all from me. Leave a comment below if something didn't work for you. Bye.